shall serve the strong. Beautiful song. Sovereign over all creation, Lord Most High, be magnified. All right, so let's sing of our hymn of the month, which is Come Behold the Wondrous Mystery. Let's think about the words as we sing. Come behold.
Come behold.
Come behold, come behold, us to be faithful.
God helps us to be faithful.
Let's say that one more time. God helps us to be faithful.
God helps us to be faithful.
All right. So let's talk about being faithful. Okay, being faithful. Who has an idea, a glimpse of an idea of what faithful, being faithful might be? What does, if I say Lena is a faithful girl, what would faithful mean? All right, Lena.
Having a lot of faith.
Having a lot of faith, okay, okay. We're getting there, we're getting warmer. Mr. Eugene.
Being full of faith,
okay, similar, okay, faithful. That's a good answer. Those are good answers, okay. But when somebody is faithful, okay, it could mean various things, but along those lines, okay, Julie.
Trusting.
Okay, trusting.
Trusting.
Trusted. Okay, yeah, someone that could be trusted, right? Yeah, that's a great answer too. So someone who is full of faith, someone who is full of faith, and someone who can be trusted, okay? What do you mean?
Like, being like, help, kind of thing.
Being what? Helpful?
Kind of helpful.
Being helpful, okay? Being faithful could mean
support.
Helpful. If that person is trustworthy, right? Trustworthy, okay, so, all right. So those are all good answers, so. Benji also
had it.
That's so cute. All right, so, here's what faithful means. Faithful means that you are dependable. Okay, someone say you are dependable.
You are dependable.
And you are committed. Someone say you are committed.
You are committed.
You're committed to a promise that you have made and that you're also trustworthy. Someone say you're trustworthy. And as a Christian, for us to be faithful means we are also full of faith, but faith in what? What are we full of faith of? Faith in?
God.
Faith in God. Man, that's a great answer. So those are all great answers. So as Christians, we have to be faithful. Someone say, we have to be faithful.
We have to be faithful.
Okay, can we tell our neighbors very gently and very respectfully, tell them, you have to be faithful.
You have to be faithful.
You have to be
faithful. Faithful to the Lord, right? Faithful to the Lord. Faithful to God. Being committed to God. Being dependable to God. Being trustworthy to God and being full of faith in God. Okay, those are all great answers. But let me ask you the next question then. Are we faithful to God? Are we always committed to God every day?
Yes.
Every moment?
Yes.
Okay, Nathan?
Yes.
You are fully committed to God every day? We don't fail Him? We don't disappoint Him?
Yeah, we do.
Okay, John?
We do.
You do, okay. Could I ask you why your answer was we do?
Because we sin.
Okay, because of our sin. Sometimes we love God and we want to be faithful to God all the time. We want to be committed. We want to be dependable. We want to be trustworthy all the time, but we fail God oftentimes because of our sin.
Okay,
Julie.
What was the question?
Okay, Mina.
You're not always faithful because we're not perfect, so we always make mistakes.
Okay, so yeah, let's just admit it. We're not perfect, right? Even though we want to remain faithful unto the Lord, it is hard because of our sin and we fall and we're not perfect. Julie?
Yeah, whether it's
Julie.
So like, we're not always faithful because we are weak humans, but it's God giving us like the faithfulness and the power. So.
Yeah. Okay, that's our next point, but let me hold you to that thought, Max.
We are sinners.
We are sinners, yes.
Same.
Even though it is a sad reality, that is the truth, but it is okay because why? Even though we are not faithful all the time, we have somebody who is helping us to be faithful. And who is that?
God.
It's God. God, okay? So, let me have a volunteer. Okay? Actually, let me have Sean. I want to be fair, because if I pick somebody, okay, so let's say being faithful means being committed to one another, okay? So I make a promise to Sean, and Sean makes a promise to me, and then when we say, all right, let's be committed, let's be faithful to one another, we shake, okay? We shake. We hold our hands like this, right? And we're in agreement that we're going to remain committed, okay? But let's say if one side is unfaithful, okay? Okay, let's say me. And if I let go, this commitment kind of breaks. But when we are in the covenant relationship with God, okay, this is what happens. So instead of us holding hands like this, we are now holding hands like this.
Oh, huh?
Why? Because if I let go, he's still holding me. That's why we are able to remain in this relationship. We let go so often because of our sin, right? Every time we lie, we let go, we disappoint God. We're to love God with all of our hearts, with all of our soul, with all of our mind, but when we sin, when we are angry, raise your hand if you get angry sometimes.
Oh, yeah, I'm
fine. All the hands went up so fast. Right, when we get angry at other people, we are being unfaithful to the Lord. Right? Even though we commit, we promise God, God, I want to be faithful to you. I want to be good to you. I want to be loving. I want to be kind. But we fail. But we are remaining in this relationship because of His faithfulness to me. Right. Okay, so we let go. He holds me. And we are remaining. All right, thank you.
Let's give a hand.
So, let's read our verse. This is our memory verse. And this verse reminds us who is faithful. Okay? Let's read together. Ready? Let's read the reference first. We always say the reference first, and we end with the reference. Ready, set, go.
Let's try that again.
We start with the reference. We end with the reference, okay? Ready, set, go.
1 Corinthians 1:9. God is faithful, by whom you were called into the fellowship of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. 1 Corinthians 1:9.
Okay? So in 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 9, it says, God is faithful. Someone say, God is faithful.
God is faithful.
Someone say, God is faithful.
God is faithful.
And then when He is faithful, what has happened? God, by God, we are called to be in fellowship. Someone say, fellowship.
Fellowship.
What is fellowship? What is fellowship? It's a fancy word for friendship or relationship. Okay, Julie? Is that what you were going to say?
Yeah.
Okay? So, we are called to be in a fellowship. Someone say fellowship.
Fellowship.
With our Savior Jesus Christ. But who, by whose faithfulness are we in the fellowship with? Whose fellowship?
His Son.
God's fellowship. God's faithfulness. I'm sorry. That was a misleading question. It is by God's faithfulness we're in that fellowship. The Bible didn't say, by your faithfulness, we are in the fellowship with God. It doesn't say that. Because God knows that we are weak in our sin. Even though we want to do what we want to do, because of our sin nature, that we still wrestle with, that we're still in the simple body, we choose to do what we don't want to do, and that is disobeying God. That is being angry at somebody. That is being untruthful, right? But we are in the fellowship with God because of whose faithfulness again?
God.
By God's faithfulness.
Of his son.
Yeah, fellowship of his son. So we are in the fellowship with Jesus Christ because of God's faithfulness. That is why we can go back and say, God is the one who is helping you to be faithful, right? God empowers us. God gives us the strength through the Holy Spirit and says, you know what? Yes, it is my faithfulness that we're in fellowship, but because I'm holding you still, even though we may let go sometimes, it is God's sovereign grace that holds us together. And when He holds us, He is enabling us to remain faithful in Him. Amen? So today, in my earlier message, it says, by God's divine power, God has given us everything that we need pertaining to life and for godliness. Meaning, God gives us all the tools. God gives us all the power. Someone say power.
Power.
To remain faithful unto Him. Amen?
Amen.
So, you will learn about a great story, Stephen. Right? Even though he was unfaithful in his sin, God gives him the power to remain faithful when the moment came for him to remain faithful and say, God, I want to remain faithful. I want to remain committed to you. I want to be a dependent disciple of you, even though my life is at risk. He was able to remain faithful because God gave him the power to be so. All right? Very quickly.
Who's Steve?
You learn.
So why did you say about like people taking on the answer like?
Oh yeah. So God helps us. God helps us to be faithful. That was a great point. Okay. Even though we're weak, God gives us the power to remain faithful. So the more we remain in the Word of God, the more we remain in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, God will give us bigger, greater strength to remain faithful when trials come, temptations come. God is going to hold us, and we would now remain in Him because He helps us to be faithful in Him. Amen? All right, let's pray. Okay. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this time. Even though we are weak in our sin, you remain faithful. You are unchanging in your love. You are steadfast in your goodness to us. And for that, once again, we come to church. For that, once again, we can pray. For that, once again, we can say, Lord, I still choose to be faithful. So, Father, Lord, as we grow in you, I pray that you grant us power and strength so that when the moments come, when there is risk, I pray that we could stand to that occasion and say, Lord, I remain committed to you. I remain faithful to you. So, Father, help us to remain faithful unto you even to the end. In Jesus Christ's name we pray.
Amen.